Oh my god! I haven't uploaded a video in such a long time. Well, today is a special occasion. From what Ian tells me, this is going to be the 2000th video that I upload to my YouTube page, and all the more reason to record a brand spanking new tarantula feeding video. So this is 123. I uploaded 122 last month, and this is consequently how often I feed my tarantulas, once a month. So we're going to go in alphabetical order, and we're going to see which ones do the greatest attack, and hope you enjoy it. Okay, so this is the very first tarantula I'm going to be feeding. This is the Acanthoscuria brocklehurstii, the giant white-banded. This is Sasha, my 6.5-inch female, hopefully gravid. Very nice. And I'll give one more. See if she's going to take it. As always, a very good eater. Okay, so this is Chelsea. She is my nearly 2.5-inch female Acanthoscuria suina, which is the sulfur brown bird eater. Like most of the Acanthoscurias, these specimens are very hungry, very avid eaters. And you can see, like, she's literally no exception. Okay, so this is one of the newer ones that I recently got at the expo. This is a suspect male, a Phonopelma cimani, which is the Costa Rican zebra. Oh, nice. Look at that. Look at you, champ. Well, certainly a lot better eater than my older female stripes that recently passed away. But I'm starting to like this little guy here. Now, it's very strange in Canada now that these are a lot more harder to find than a couple years ago, and they also cost an arm and a leg. So hopefully if I do find a female for this one, I'd like to breed this one and start selling them so we can get them a little bit cheaper. This one I got for $60 at Slimebeard's at the table. But very good. This is one of the freshest tarantulas I recently acquired. This is the Evicularia vicularia, regular pink toe female. This one I'm probably going to name Bootsy, since she's got really cute pink toes. Alright, see how she does. Fuzzy wuzzy, said the spider. She looks really, really good. Yeah. Alright, so this is going to be very tough to see, because I am starting to film at night, and I don't have very good lighting in there, but you can see Trinity over here. She is my Vicularia versicolor, the Antilles pink toe. This is the largest that I have, and this is the second one and only one in my collection as of this date. Alright, so oh, nice, Trinity. She got it. Alright. Just want to show you the colors of the Vicularia versicolor. These are actually one of my favorite pink toes in terms of color. I mean, you can't really get any colorful than that. Well, yeah, of course, there's Vicularia diversipes, which is the sapphire pink toe. But this is the one that Shannon sold to me almost 5 years ago and still doing a-okay. Alright, so this is my male Brachypalma albiceps. This is a Mexican gold red rump. and then if he eats, that'll be good, and I'll show Stacy, which is my larger female. Yeah, come on, of course he's gonna eat. He's a big boy. Hopefully he's gonna mature, and we'll start mating these guys once both of them are ready. So here she is. This is my mature female, Stacy. You can see that she's pretty much ginormous compared to that little guy. So let's see if she's gonna eat. Okay, so she missed that one. She's a little bit more picky in terms of eating compared to the male. I guess not this time. Alright, this little guy here is Leon. He is my male, Brachypelma auratum, the Mexican flamey. My female, Ada, wasn't interested in eating, so I didn't record her. Leon is just a powerhouse when it comes to feeding. As you can see. Gonna give him a little superworm for her, for this guy right here. I mean, if you want to compare it to my female, here she is. They're about the same size, but unfortunately, he's probably going to mature much more faster than she is, but they're all good. So this is Aragog. She's a cutie, also very hairy. So this is my curly hair female, Brachypelma albopilosum. A very nice tarantula for the beginner. And a super strong eater too. And you can see. Oh, there we go, some fang action going on. I mean, this is a tarantula with a permanently bad hair day. Just imagine having to comb her hair 24/7. Yeah. I thought she liked the idea of combing. Yeah. Comb me, John. Love to have straight hair, but I think she's just pretty like that. Okay, so this is Curly Sue. The second, this is the other curly hair female. Nice pounce, Sue. A little bit edgy at times, but wait till she gets older and she's going to be just as calm as original Sue. I love that one. Ever since I bought tarantulas for about 20 years, my previous curly hair, which was Sue, the original one, she died at 28 years old, and I've had her for about 20 years, and I bought her as an adult back in 96, so yeah, she was the loved one. Alright, this is a very nice female. This is Chimera. She is my Brachypelma Bohmi cross Bumgarteni, one of my two hybrids that I have in my collection. This is called the Mexican Orange Beauty. And as you can see, Chimera is no exception to my Brachypelmas. Very strong eater. And she looks really nice looking, especially with the fire red legs and the triangle on the carapace. Too bad it's not the real Bumgarteni, but I still love her just as much as any other of my teas. I'm not going to breed her, so it's just going to be like a nice showpiece. This one here is Melina II. This is the Brachypelma Bohmi Mexican Fireleg. stunning eater, as you can probably see. Never refuses food, one of my stronger Brachypelmas next to the Classy. This is a really nice Brachypelma and a super, super good eater. So this is the Brachypelma Classy. This is the Mexican pink that I dubbed Petunia. I mean, she looks like a petunia. Gorgeous flower and gorgeous tea. So let's see her do her magic against the superworm. Blonk. Oh, there you go. Yeah, she's hunting for it. I want to see her dig it up like a little dog. There we go. Come on, girl. You can do it, girl. Oh! Oh, show me the fangs. That's my girl. I mean, she's just a pleasure to look at and to feed. One of the most popular teas in the hobby, and it's essentially what got me interested in the tea collecting. This is a Brachypelma Smithy Mexican Red Knee. This is Athena, 5-inch female. Gorgeous female at that. Yeah, just like the Classy, excellent eater, and certainly very, very colorful. And of course, how can I not forget Scarlet? She's the one that actually got me into making YouTube videos. First started in 2007. Oh, nice! Some discoloration on the legs, but that's to be expected. She's really growing quickly. She's probably about like 9, 10 years old. Still a very young female. Alright, so this is another skittish Brachypelma that I have. This is a B. vagans Mexican Red Rump. And, yep, there we go. Alright, so this is the last unique Brachy that I have in my collection. This is a Brachypelma Verdesi, which is the Mexican Rose Gray. This is a female named Kalinka. Wow, look at that. Instantaneous. Wow, you go, girl. I love her extreme red hairs on her abdomen. Looking a little bit different than Annette, the vagans you just seen earlier. This very, very haunted enclosure belongs to Julin, my crazy Chilobrachys guanaciensis, the Chinese fawn. She's got 7 legs. She did lose her leg at some point in time, but it does not deter her. I just missed it. And just because she has 7 legs doesn't really deter her from not eating. As you can see, very, very strong and healthy female. Raised since 2011. Crazy how thick her webbing is. Alright, must have in everyone's collection, GBB, the Chromatopelma cyanopubescens. Look at that. What amazing determination that this little species has. And keep in mind, this is only a sling, and you only get up to about 5.5-6 inches, and they're really going to be pretty in color once they get older. Just wait till you see this specimen, how fast this is going to grow. My last sling took about 2 years to mature, and it was a male that I named Mark. Alright, next up is Mystery. She is my Cithracanthus livingstoni. This is the Livingston's tea. Hiding behind in the corner. See if I can try to draw her out. Like, she's really gorgeous. Alright, see if I could try to make her come out for us. Come on. Okay. Oh, there she comes. Here she comes. She'll be coming around the mountain when she comes. Come on, baby. She'll be coming around the mountain when she comes. Do 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 do. And you are impressive. Nice fang action going on. There we go. What a sweetie. Alright, so this is Gordon Ramsay. Cuban pygmy. Also known as Crichtopholis ramsayi. I'm giving him a raw cricket, so let's hope he doesn't punish me with his swear words. Come here, you donkey! Really? He's not hungry. Gordon usually eats. Well, he is pretty old. Or maybe... Come on. There we go. Look at that Michelin star attack. Yeah, this is definitely a mature male. You can see his tibial hooks on the first pair of legs, his bulbous pedipalps. It's too bad that the females are sold out in Tarantula Canada. They don't even have any. This next one here is Stella. She is my Cyclosternum fasciatum, the Costa Rican tiger rump. Let's go see how my pink angry tarantula eats. I guess not. Alright, this one here is my psychopathic. Truly she is. Cyclosternum species Macala, which is known as the Peruvian peach collared. Yeah, this is the one that gave me the most trouble when I was rehousing this one. So, let's see how well she does on her first feeding attempt. Ooh! I can see that she still has not changed in her attitude. Wow. I think we got a feisty one here. And is this one here? I have no idea what to call this one. I do know it's female. And just talking to her, and she's threading. Definitely much more defensive than Stella. Alright, let's try again for that Peruvian peach-colored species. The Cyclosternum species Macala. And this time I got her to eat. Yes. There we go. Nice. Alright, see what we have here. This is my Daemon Diadema, or Talus Whip Scorpion. She is ready to pounce. Soon as this cricket decides to leave its little burrow it created, kaplunk. And there she be, Dinah, Talus Whip Scorpion. This is one of my non-venomous arachnids, and also great for the beginners. Very docile, but extremely fast-moving, and very simple to take care of. I mean, this is my adult female, and she's in a 1 gallon jar with substrate and a cork bark and a water dish, and I've had her almost 2 years now. It's doing fine. I'm a regular, fellas. This is Cleveland. He is my Iphopopus rufescens male, which is known as the Burgundy Skeleton. A regular eater in my videos because it's... he's always putting on a good show. And there he is. That's what the Burgundy Skeleton looks like. Not especially colorful as the E. marinus and the E. saronathus, which is the blue fang for the saronathus and the skeleton. But it's still a very nice tarantula to look at. I'm hoping that he molts soon. It's been ages since he last has. This one here is a nice run here. This is the Euaphlus perculmaclassi, which is the Chilean blue-green femur. I'll name this one Tikal from Sonic Adventures. Ooh, nice one. Yeah, you can really see that. It's hard to tell. She does have a purple sheen on her femurs. Yeah, I could just make it out here, but I think she's in due for a molt. Okay, we can see a little bit of the leg here. We know who that is. This is my stout-legged baboon female, Eucratus celsus pachypus. Oh, nice one. That is a nice girl. And your typical pet hole. Just loves to burrow. Alright, so it's time to feed Espa. This is the high yellow hypomorph leopard gecko. So let's see if she's going to eat. Did feed her yesterday, so maybe that's why. Yeah, certainly a very chubby lady. Oh, nice, Roy. What a good old boy. So this is my immature male, Gramacola pulchra. This is the Brazilian black, one of the blackest teas that I own in my collection. Always a great eater. So I do apologize for some of the lighting in the video. It's 11:39 in the evening as I'm recording. Anyway, here is big old Ebony. She is currently my oldest living tarantula at the moment. Gramisola pulchra female. Alright, so let's see if I can try to get some fang action going on. I mean, she's very... She isn't a very oppressive female. I'm not sure if she got it. Oh. I think she almost had it. Oh, there we go, there we go. There we go, and look at her. Look at her. Yes, ha ha ha. You can tell that she's a really, really cool female. And she's about 7 inches. That's pretty much the typical growth rate of, typical size of your G. pulchra. Alright, ladies and gents, this is Wendy, my Gramisola pulchra piece, Chaco Goldeny. This is one of my 3 females. I tried feeding Don's mature male. Doesn't seem to be wanting to eat. It's pretty normal for mature males since their main focus is to find females, but I know this female definitely is going to eat. Ah, there we go. You see that? She doesn't disappoint me. Yep. Another great looking tea. Also recommended for the beginner, since it does have a relatively nice temperament. Except this one. This one is a little bit mean, but otherwise not too bad. Now this one here is Princess Peach. She is my other Chaco Goldeny. This is the sister of Wendy that you just seen just before. Right, let's see how... Oopsie. Didn't mean to do that. But let's see if she's gonna get it this time. Time for take 2. There we go. Come on. That's it. It's a little closer. A little closer, then you're gonna have a nice, nice meal. There she goes. Yeah, as you can see, that peach recently has molted about 1.5 months ago. I had the opportunity to film her post-molt and sex her molt to show you that she was 100% female. And she's pretty colorful. So she's probably the one that I'm going to pair up with Luigi, since she's freshly molted and she's raring to go. Just gotta feed her a little bit more and then just mate them and see what happens. But I think we'll have a good mating attempt. So I'm just gonna keep feeding her. Hopefully this week I'll try to pair them up, as well as the Pekin Cerides, since it's been a while since I last mated them. Alright, this one here is Charlotte. It's a pretty common name for most tarantula owners. Those of you who read the book Charlotte's Web, it's a fantastic book. And ultimately that's what got me into spiders. So let's see if Charlotte is going to eat now. Enclosure has seen better days. I do have to possibly get a new one.
beautiful. There we go. What a nice girl. So everyone knows this tarantula, very familiar, sold in pet stores. This one's the common rosehair or Gramostola rosea. This one here is the normal color form, the one with the pink carapace. This one is Michaela. She is a female. And it's very hard to see her enclosure with the webbing, but as you can see that she ate well. Sometimes your rose hairs do go on a feeding fast. That's pretty normal. And there's really no surefire way to get your tarantula to eat when it's refusing to eat. All you have to do is just keep on trying, keep on trying. I know it may require a lot of patience, and then eventually they just do snap out of it. This rose hair hasn't really eaten since feeding video 121, and I just kept feeding her eventually, and here we go. I mean, she just broke out her 2-month feeding fast. It's a really nice spider. But again, individuals do vary, and most of these rose hairs, unfortunately, do have some temperamental mood swings. So it's always important to test the temperament with a paintbrush before you decide to handle them. But she did really great, and I'm really happy that she's eating. She's got a nice sized abdomen, so she's pretty healthy. Alright, let's go check on some of the other ones. Now, the big question today is, will Talia eat? This is my other rose hair, normal form. She's the one that's very picky. And is currently on her feeding fast for like her 4th or 5th month already. And nothing. This one is 100% gonna eat. This is Angelica. This is the last rose hair normal form that I have. There we go. That's how rose hair should eat. And again, she's relatively younger than Talia and Michaela, so very, very good. Alright, so I'm really low on crickets. I might have to get some. Alright, so the tarantula you're looking here is Morris Rose. He is my Gramostola rosea red face. Looks like he missed. Nah, he got it this time. Nice. Yeah, this is a legitimate 6-year-old specimen, so don't believe when pet stores will tell you that a full-grown rose hair is 1 year old. This one here is 6 years old. Just goes to show you how really slow-growing your rose hairs can be. Now let's try this one. It is a Gramostola species mall, which is called an orange fluff tarantula. A really nice name. And name this girl Laura, of course, from the Evil Within character. She's has a red dress, and the monster that she turns into by Ruvik ends up being a spider monster. Oop. Yeah, she's buying the wrong thing. Superworm is trying to play dead. Alright, let's try another one. It's a much more lively one. And she's probably going to take that one. Yeah, just look at her finesse. There we go. She grabs it so gently. Yeah, this was the tea that I bought on my birthday this past November. This one here is Haplopus species Columbia large, the pumpkin patch. This is Kina, a young female. Snapped. Yeah. I'll make a Mythbuster video on this very soon. Pretty easy to take care of. They are certainly very similar to the Cereocosmos in care. They require deep substrate to burrow. Semi-moist, not too wet, not too dry. And temperature is pretty normal. I named this one Kina after Zelda, the Skyward Sword. Alright, this one here is my largest baboon that I have so far, currently. This is my adult female Histiocrates gigas, the Cameroon Red Baboon, named Elena, after the character in Street Fighter Third Strike on the Dreamcast. There we go, such precision. Very nice one. This one here is Kachiana Brunipeeps, the dwarf pink leg. I call this one Kagome, after, of course, Inuyasha. Bingo. I showed you in the last feeding video how pretty these guys are. Yeah, she might be due for a rehouse, but they don't get very large. About 2-2.5 inches is probably the max they grow. It's really cool, their pink legs and their black bodies. A very fun tarantula to own for sure. And a quick grower, too. Alright, everyone. This spider here is going to give everyone the heebie-jeebies. This is the Latrodectus hesperus, the Black Widow. And there we go. Currently, she's spinning her webs. As you can see, they're very thick.